Hey everybody, so in the next couple of videos we're going to start talking about the laws that govern the behavior of gases. And in this video we're going to talk about one of those such laws. We're going to talk about Boyle's law. So Boyle's law was invented by this strapping young gentleman over here. This is Robert Boyle. And Boyle's law explains why this little diagram over here doesn't really make any sense. So you may have seen in the cartoons where people will use like an extra long snorkel to hide out underwater, and the long snorkel enables them to breathe. But Boyle's law explains why this would never ever work. So let's go into what Boyle's law actually describes. So the basic idea with Boyle's law, and indeed all gas laws, is that you have four basic properties of gases, which are the pressure, P, the volume, V, the temperature, T, and the amount in moles, N. So these are the four basic properties of gases. And Boyle's law governs the relationship between the pressure of a gas and the volume of a gas, assuming that the temperature and the amount in moles are kept constant. So the way that Robert Boyle determined this behavior between pressure and volume, well, it was actually Robert Boyle and his assistant, Robert Hooke. They used this device here called the J-tube. And so using this J-shaped glass tube, they were able to trap a gas inside this tube. So one end of the tube is stoppered, and we have a gas that's trapped in by this mercury here. So the mercury is poured through this end, and that traps the gas in on this side of the tube. And so what they did was they can measure the pressure of this gas, because again, you have atmospheric pressure that's pushing down this way, and then you have the pressure of the gas that's pushing this way. And you can measure that pressure in millimeters of mercury simply by measuring the height between the two mercury levels. Well, what Robert Boyle and Robert Hooke did is they added some more mercury to the J-tube. And what that did was increased the pressure. So by adding more mercury, they pressurized this gas even further. And they found that the volume of the gas, so this portion right here where the gas is kept, actually decreased. So an increase in pressure brought about a decrease in volume. And again, we can definitely understand how the pressure is increased just again by measuring the height between the two levels of mercury before we added the extra mercury and then after we added the extra mercury. Notice that the H term, that height, is much longer, it's much taller once we added more mercury, and that indicates that you have more pressure. So increasing the pressure of this system decreased its volume. And so what Robert Boyle and Robert Hooke found was that it's an inverse relationship between pressure and volume, meaning that V, the volume, is inversely proportional to the pressure. So that means that the volume is directly proportional, which is what this symbol means. The volume is directly proportional to the reciprocal of the pressure. V is proportional to 1 over P. Now, chemists don't normally like proportionalities. They'd rather turn them into an equation. But luckily, we can turn this proportionality into an equation very simply by saying that the volume is equal to 1 over the pressure times a constant. And then finally, if we multiply both sides of this equation here by the pressure, we will get that the product of the pressure and volume is equal to a constant. So that means that, and this is, again, this is all assuming that the temperature and the amount of the gas in moles are kept the same. That means that the pressure times the volume is always going to be equal to some constant. So as you increase the pressure, you're decreasing the volume, but the product of those two terms is always going to be the same number. So that means that if you have a compression where you're decreasing the volume, or you have an expansion where you're increasing the volume and decreasing the pressure at the same time, so if you have two states, so to speak, where you have a compressed state and an expanded state, those two can be represented by this equation here, where you have the product of the pressure and volume for state 1 is equal to the product of pressure and the volume for state 2. So P1 V1 equals P2 V2. So this equation, again, this is assuming that the temperature and the amount of the gas are kept the same throughout the entire process. If those two conditions are satisfied, then this equation works quite well. So let's go into a problem real quick. So it says that we have a balloon, and that balloon has a pressure, it has some gas in it, and it's kept at a pressure of 5.00 atmospheres, and it's got a volume of 10.0 liters. And what happens is that balloon is compressed to a final volume of 1.00 liters. And we're asked to find the pressure of that compressed balloon. So again, we're going to use our P1 V1 equals P2 V2. We're going to assume that state 1 is that expanded state where we have a big volume of 10 liters and a pressure of 5.00 atmospheres. So that means that the product of 5.00 atmospheres and 10.0 liters is going to be equal to the product of the pressure at that compressed state times that new volume, which is 1.00 liters. And then, of course, to solve for that P2 term, all we have to do is to divide both sides of this equation by that 1.00 liters. The liters terms are going to cancel, so we get 5 times 10 taken to three significant figures, which is equal to 50.0 atmospheres, which is a very high pressure. So we have a very high pressure balloon right here. So that's basically how you do problems involving Boyle's law. And again, always check to make sure that the temperature and the amount in moles are kept constant throughout the process. If that's not the case, then it's like all bets are off. Boyle's law does not work when the temperature and the amount of the gas are allowed to change. And so before we end the video, I'd like to return back to this long snorkel example. So let's assume that this diver here is at a depth of 20 meters below the water level. So basically what happens when you start going deeper and deeper into the water, for every 10 meters deep you go into the water, your lungs and your whole body experience an additional 1 atmosphere of pressure caused by all the weight of that water above you. So if you're 20 meters deep, like this guy here, that means that he's actually experiencing a pressure of 3 atmospheres. There's the 1 atmosphere coming from just the air pressure, plus an additional 2 atmospheres from that 20 meter depth that he finds himself in. So down here, he's trying to breathe in at a pressure of 3 atmospheres, and he's trying to breathe out over here at a pressure of 1 atmosphere. So what would happen here is this additional 2 atmospheres of pressure is going to force air out of his lungs, and he would not be able to inhale again. So this is why an extra long snorkel at a depth of 20 meters would definitely not work, despite what you may have seen from the cartoons. All right, so that is Boyle's law. We're going to definitely talk about some more of the gas laws in the near future, so stay tuned for that. All right, take care.